Gemfields supplies coloured gemstones, and today the company's told investors that nearly all of its rubies on offer at its latest auction have been snapped up, generating over $16 million in revenue. Ian Harebottle is the chief executive. He joins us on the line now. So, Ian, what does this auction say about the quality of the rubies and the demand from the market?
Well, most importantly, in terms of demand, demand continues to be strong. We're very excited about the gemstone industry in general, but specifically coloured stones and very much rubies. Naturally, this auction was our lower quality. To date with emeralds, we've got a very good track record. We alternate auctions between higher quality and low quality. This is only our third ruby auction. So the first one was a mixed bag. The first one was higher quality, and this is our first lower quality. And I think we kind of got the methodology, and going forward we'll probably continue to have higher and lower quality auctions. And so the overall revenue and dollar per carat for this auction was considerably less than for the previous one, but most importantly we are still very, very excited, because I think a lot of people forget the largest retailer of diamonds in the world by dollar value is Walmart. So while the superstars, and I think we just recently saw this very big diamond going for big prices, and while that's all very important, it is the more commercial gems of all natures that are important, and that's exactly what this auction was. And the fact that everything, almost everything was sold, shows you that it has a really good, important place, and the demand is strong.
Now, some of your gems you buy on the open market and then auction. So how can you make a profit on these?
That's a very small percentage. So the vast majority for our emerald, our ruby, and our amethyst mine is focused on the mines themselves. But by the same token, and it's mainly focusing in the jurisdictions where we operate, but some expansion into other areas. We have seen to date that a lot of gems are available in the markets, whether it's Zambia or Mozambique, etc. And we generally feel they're being bought up at a price that's too low. That doesn't help the other miners who have to survive and continue to invest. And very often, and full taxes, etc., and that aren't paid. So one would think it's difficult to buy, but the advantage Gemfields has is that when we buy some product in the market, we can then sort and grade it, and when we offer it to our customers, it's a good match with some of the mine goods. And a very clever customer coming along, you'll see, oh, there they've got their mine goods on offer. That is bought in the local market, and together they'll make a good set, and it allows me to make more gems, which I can fit into more jewelry, which I can support with more marketing and create more demand. So it's good for our customers, it's good for us, and it's very good for the jurisdictions where we operate, because it allows more transparency and more revenue to flow into those countries and into the other miners who we see as almost fellow miners and as industry associates, certainly not competitors.
Okay, let me ask you about those jurisdictions, because, how important to you is it to auction when you want, what you want? Because I'm thinking about the Zambian government. It insists on the Cajun emerald auctions taking place in Zambia. Does this hinder you at all? Are you constrained?
Well, there's two sides to that answer. On the one hand, I think if you ask any CEO of any company, and he would say to you, it's very important, or we believe it's important to have autonomy and have independence and have the ability to make decisions that we believe are best for our company and best for our product and best for our industry as and when we want. So from that perspective, the answer would be yes, it's very important to us. But on the other side, and this is again true for every CEO and everybody in the world, is one does operate in jurisdictions, and when you are operating in these jurisdictions, you have to respect their governments, you have to respect their people, you have to respect their own challenges. And so while, we certainly believe international auctions closer to the customers, where it's more convenient for our customers so we can build more demand for our Mozambican rubies and our Zambian emeralds and so on, while we see a lot of benefit, we also realize that there are certain challenges within the jurisdictions that we operate. And so we always, as a company, we always fully committed to abiding by the laws and regulations under which we operate. But at the same time, we also continue to work with our governments to educate them and say, okay, this is what you need. We understand that. By the same token, this is where we see it. And hopefully at some point in time, we can come to, very, and generally we do. To date, I'm very pleased. we've managed to come to situations where we all see, you know, what's right for everybody, and we're able to implement that in a very successful way.
Okay, finally, Ian, and a quick answer, please. Bonhams, the auction house, describes 2015 as the year of the coloured gemstones. So where does that leave 2016?
Just more and more. So that's a wonderful thing. If this is the year of coloured gemstones, I think this is just the year of the beginning of coloured gemstones. I think then the years coming are going to be more and more as colour starts to play a more and more important role. In fact, funny thing, for the last couple of years, people have said to me, you know, what do you think now? And I've said, this is just the beginning. And I've said it every year with more conviction. So I think and history is proving me to be right.
Ian Harebottle, Chief Executive of Gemfields, thank you very much indeed for joining us.